In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to make launchable icons in LinuxSTEAM that allow you to launch applications from WindowsSTEAM. For example, RPG Maker XP. This application is not available on Linux. As you can see, it's grayed out, a package tray, and if I right, you can go install app. It says it's on a developed platform. But this program does work on the Wine, which I can use to run it. For example, if I open up my PR on Linux and I click on run, it will connect to my Steam account, which is running Steam through Wine, and then I can click launch, and bam. Now, wouldn't it be nice if I didn't have to open up Steam and open up PR on Linux every single time I want to do this? Well, yes, it would be, and I actually found a way to do this. As you see here, if you make an XP, click play, we'll see a command window pop up for a few seconds, and then it's going to connect to my Steam account, and then it's going to launch RPG Maker XP. So yeah, and it works perfectly because it's just running on the Wine, so, yep. So in this video, I'm going to be using RPG Maker VX as an example. So to do this, you just want to, first off, go into the WindowsSTEAM. So to do that, I'm just gonna open up this and I'll click on the library. Alright, and I'm gonna go over to RPG Maker VX. Now I'm going to click right click and you want to create desktop shortcut. That'll place a shortcut on your desktop. Now from there you can see RPG Maker VX.url. You can't run this as is, however you can open it and edit it with an application such as a cant to edit a text or any text editor really work. And you'll see this here, URL equals theme colon CSS, one game ID CSS, and then a number. You want to copy this data, and then you want to head over to the PR Linux. Then you want to click on configure. And then you want to click on Wine, and then command prompt on the virtual drive that contains the Steam installation. And then you want to go over here to your C drive. You can really go anywhere on your thing, as long as it's on your C drive somewhere. And now you just want to type in stout, and then that ID, just get that thing code you just entered in. To do this, what should happen is the program associated with it should launch. Great. Now we want to make it so we want to automate this. So to do that, we just want to go echo, and then the program, and then stout, and then edit paste. Alright, and then you want to do this symbol, and then something you'll remember. For example, RM of VX in my case. And then end it in .batch. Okay. Now that we've done that, it will create a file called rmvx on the thing. So now, you want to head over to general, make a thing from the virtual drive. And first, you want to actually, create a virtual drive of the original, of the exe file. As we have already done that here, I'm actually going to quickly uninstall it so you guys know what I mean. So I'm going to remove this little shortcut quickly. You guys see what I mean? I'm going to just remove that. And now I'm going to go to settings. Oh, no, I meant configure, Steam, general make shortcut in the virtual drive. And we'll scan the virtual drive, and then you should see up here, RPG VX. Alright, or whatever program you're using, you want to click on that, and then you want to add main exe file, so RPG Maker VX in my case, you just want to add that as a shortcut. Now, you can't launch this unless you have WindowsSTEAM running, but it's important you make a shortcut this way first, and you say I don't, and then after you make that shortcut, you then want to go down and click on that batch file you just created, and you want to click on that and click next. Now you want to name it the exact same thing, RPG Maker VX. Alright, and it's going to ask if you want to override it, so you're going to click yes. And then it's going to take a while, and it's going to eventually say yep, and then you can just close out of that. Okay, so now to test it, you should be able to click on RPG Maker VX without WindowsSTEAM running. Now remember, this can be any application you want, it doesn't have to be RMVX, it can be just any Steam application at all. Alright, you just want to click run, or debug, either one. And you should see this whole process go through. Steam should pop up. for a few seconds, and then it should connect to your Steam account, and then it should open up the program that you set it to. So as you see, it just did. It worked perfectly. This shortcut works. So then, you just want to right-click this, not configure one. I keep clicking on configure one. I'll right-click this and go to, I guess you don't actually want to right-click it, just right-click create shortcut. Alright, this will create the shortcut on your desktop. Then just right-click next. Alright. Now on my desktop, I should see AppGMakerVX.desktop here. Now I just want to open up Steam. And I want to actually right-click on the original icon, and I want to click set categories, hide this game in my library. So now it's hidden, and I just want to go add game, add a non-Steam game. Now you want to go browse, and you want to find your, you want to find that desktop icon it created. It should be on your desktop, if odd enough, you would have guessed, right? So yeah, AppGMakerVX.desktop, open. And if I click add certain programs, it should appear in my thing under uncategorized, because I haven't actually categorized it yet. And now I can go properties, and I'm going to, you know, I don't know properties yet, you go categories, and you can put it wherever the hell you want. Looks like I geeked out my Steam a bit there. I'll just quickly fix that. But yeah, if you have here, I'll put it under AppGMaker, you can put it anywhere you want. Alright, and now I just want to head over to, uncategorized. Alright, you want to head on here, and now you should have this thing here, but there's a problem. If you click play on this, all it's going to do is just open up another version of play on Linux. And the reason for this is because Steam is stupid, you can't see that you don't want to do that. So what you want to do is just want to click these properties here, and you want to set your launch options. So open that, and you want to right click on your .desktop file and go open with cate. And then you should see a thing here that says dash run, and then the name of your thing, and then percentage F. You just want to take that your thing from your .desktop file, and you want to put it in that launch options. Now you want to click OK, you want to close out of that, you want to open up Steam, and now you click J. The whole process should begin. I have it running through and running VX. Which really does take forever, by the way. I hate Steam. Alright. So, yeah. But the thing is, there's no icon. This one here is actually completely optional. You can go over the properties. You can go over the properties if you want. Change icon. And then you just want to head up to, your home directory. Your home directory. Then you want to head down to .playonLinux, and then you want to click on icon is, and then full size. And then you won't see this. You will still see a completely jank file. What you want to do is you want to head over to there on your, I don't know, any file browser at all, and you just want to head over to icon is full size. Now, you won't see the PNG files like you will here. You'll just see these here, but unfortunately, Steam is stupid and can't see these. So what you want to do is just want to quickly copy them, and you just want to paste it and add .png as the extension. Alright, and then Steam should be able to see them. I could always see them though, because I always did that. I did that off camera, because I've done this multiple times, and it never freaking worked. But now it's actually working. So there we go, I added an icon. Alright, and I'll hit J. Bam. Perfect. And you can do this any Steam app you want, just repeat the process. Really young process, I know, it's annoying, but it works. So yeah. That's about it for this video. Thank you for watching.